There's growing concern from authorities tonight over rising COVID case numbers in our regions, with far western New South Wales especially vulnerable. Despite this, residents in Wilcannia say they're being let down.
It's a part of New South Wales that feels isolated at the best of times, but in Wilcannia, when you add COVID to the mix, it feels worse.
You know, you people put us as vulnerable in it. You've classed us as vulnerable, but you couldn't even support us.
Wilcannia resident Monica Kerwin doesn't hold back, directing her anger and frustration at government, state and Commonwealth.
I live in the midst of this, so don't sit up on your high horse carrying on like you got this all under control. We get low on food. Where we got to go? We got to go through a roadblock.
Basic supplies here are a problem. Enter Tanoa Bugmi and her team of volunteers from Broken Hill, gathering donated essential supplies and driving them in an ambulance 200 kilometres to Wilcannia.
We prioritise people who are tested positive with COVID and who are in isolation due to close contacts. Yesterday we sent over about $1,000 worth of baby essentials.
Wilcannia and Broken Hill had just three cases to 8pm last night, but 15 more emerged after that time. Western New South Wales had 24 new cases, mostly in Dubbo. Hunter New England, the Central Coast and Illawarra Shoalhaven each had two new cases.
Wilcannia's a remote community who's constantly been let down by government.
The Deputy Premier admits Wilcannia is a concern but defends the response so far.
When you say it's a mess out there, it's not. It's a very coordinated whole-of-government approach, including ADF and the Royal Flying Doctors over the weekend.
Overall, Western New South Wales remains the hot zone for our regions. 283 cases so far in this outbreak, 234 in Dubbo alone.
We know in just about all of our communities at the moment there is a very high risk of COVID. If it's not already there, there's a very good chance it will be.
Health officials acknowledge the difficulty hospitals and medical services outside of Sydney face if case numbers continue to rise.
Have some comfort in knowing that we understand that the regions will be stretched and we're ready to help in any way we can.
In the far west, though, actions may well speak louder.
None of them action plans have I seen once rolled out here. Come out of here. Come to Wilcannia. Come fully protected too.
Eddie Meyer,